Hello there. Welcome to Reykjavík Grettisson's Newscast. My name is Valur Grettisson. I'm an editor-in-chief at Reykjavík Grettisson. This is, of course, my dear friend and little helper, Polly. She's a chief of morale officer at Reykjavík Grettisson. And probably the best staff worker here with the lowest payment also. we're going to go through news, but before, of course, I want to remind you on High Five Club and, of course, our shop. You can actually get mittens like this, similar to the Bernie mittens, but, of course, not the same ones. And, yeah, let's do news. One person were tested positive with COVID yesterday, which means that we're still with everything under constraint, which is quite remarkable because most nations around us, at least in Europe, are having a very hard time because, well, the people are not like safe enough over the holidays, which is pretty good. And also this one person was in quarantine, which means that it's even more of a success. Almost 17 people are at the hospital, which is, of course, always bad, but nobody is in intensive care, so we're like, it's safe to say we have COVID under control right now, but domestically there is, but the people that are coming to the country, they are often like, those numbers are much higher than the others. Almost 5,000 people have been vaccinated in Iceland. This is going slower than many would have thought in Iceland, but we are, keep in mind, 5,000 people in Iceland is like 1.5% of the nation, so it could be worse, of course. Also, Visir.is, the biggest news site in Iceland, they called or messaged all the members of the parliament in Iceland and asked them, are you going to get the flu, are you going to get vaccinated? And 54 have answered, and they've all said yes. So the rest haven't answered yet for some reasons. Perhaps they just didn't see the message, or they just do not want to answer the question. But it's quite something. Also, our epidemiologist Thorvaldur Gunnarsson is very happy with this result. That is with how good we are doing right now. Because, like, of course, we're not dealing with this backlash and many nations after holidays. But it says it's still too early to lift any restrictions or change anything. It means basically that we have these restrictions going on. It's like the heaviest one is the gathering ban is 20. And it's going to be like that until at least 17th of February. After that, we have to ask ourselves, do we want to like lift it even further? A lot of businesses, of course, would be very happy to see more people on the streets, but as you can see, it's like not much is happening right now. And this is how it goes. Now we're going to politics. The Icelandic politics are getting more lively now for this because this is an election year. We're going to have elections in the beginning of the fall, which is a little bit later than usual. It's usually in like May. But because we have had like a lot of political turmoil last years, and some of you remember, there was this Panama Papers scandal in 2017, sorry, and it ended up that the government at the time, the Progressive Party and the Independence Party, broke up in the coalition. So we're going to have elections in the fall, which is perhaps like it's new, it's perhaps fun and at least a different kind of time, but it means that all of the parties are now preparing who to find their candidates and put them on the list, and there is interesting, but perhaps not for the international audience. But there are some scary news because this weekend the Social Democrats in Iceland, which is in Iceland called Samfylkingin, they found out that someone shot at their headquarters. When the manager of the party came to work, she saw that there was like a bullet hole in one of the windows at the office. And this was obviously someone that's shot at the office. And what's perhaps more alarming is that this is not the first time that this has happened past 2 years at least. The same have happened in the, for the Independence Party or Sjálfstæðisflokkurinn, which is perhaps a more controversial party in Iceland. They are now ruling, they have the financial minister and so on. And this also happened to the Pirate Party. For no apparent reason, the connections is very odd in so many ways. So we don't really understand what's going on, but the police is actually investigating this and they are taking this quite seriously, which means that we have to, like, perhaps we would even, we will perhaps get this perp. Luckily, this is only a, like an air gun. It's not a, like a shotgun or a handgun or something like that. Remember, there is, there are no guns in Iceland, but we have, of course, hunting rifles and a lot of them, of course. We have over 70,000 weapons registered in Iceland, which is interesting in itself. You can actually read about it at greipan.is. Also, there was a new poll that was introduced this weekend that Channel 2 and Vísir made, and it shows that there is a new party in town, which is quite remarkable because it's the Socialist Party. Icelanders haven't had a Socialist Party in Iceland, I think, ever. So this is quite the news that the Socialist Party is emerging into Icelandic politics. And this seems to be on the cost of populism in Iceland. We have an alt-right party in Iceland. They, of course, do not say, would never admit it to themselves that they are one, but that's the middle party, or miðflokkurinn. They are going down, and the Socialist Party, for some reason, is going up, which is on the opposite of the end of the political scale, which we find is very, very interesting. And finally, a little bit of self-promotion here. Tomorrow at 3 o'clock in Icelandic time, that is 1500 hours, if you, wherever you are, the Reykjavik Greipan will hold its fifth Ask Me Anything, or AMA. And of course, me and Andy, we're going to do this together. Andy is our news editor, Fréttastjóri would it be in Icelandic. And you can actually join us, but you have to, of course, be a part of our High Five Club membership. We'll answer your questions, or if you have any questions, whatever it could be. Kodi? It doesn't matter what it is. You can ask me where I got these beautiful mittens here, or you could ask what's up with the Northern Lights, or just how things are going. It doesn't really matter. We will be there, and we will answer the questions. And finally, basically, this is it for the news. Thanks for watching, of course. It's always fun to show you the city. It's quite calm right now. And we are just hanging in there. You do the same. Also, to the Americans, of course, congratulations to the new president. It's quite the news. So, hope that will work out somehow, and perhaps someone will take COVID more serious in that country. But until then please tune in, like and subscribe. Remember our online shop. Remember, we have mittens and books. Books I absolutely love. Which reminds me, I need to tell you perhaps what I love the most from the shop. We're preparing for that. We also have like a Valentine's box that Hannah Jane Cohen, our editor-in-chief of culture in I'm messing this up somehow, but anyway, Hannah Jane is doing like a Valentine box. It should be available in hopefully a few days, so keep on checking that store. Until then, goodbye, and I'm gone.